Good morning. My name is Clarice Fulber-Page, and I'm here representing SWAN and the community. And the homeowners that are here today are a part of the SWAN network at this point. Guys, the bottom line is we don't need any more apartments. We have been through this over the last decade with apartments. And I say that we don't need any more apartments because we have at least 14 apartment complexes along Six Flags. And it goes all the way down to the Walton Reserve, which is on Oak Ridge, just a continuation of the Six Flags Road corridor. This additional apartment complex would add, I believe, our 14th apartment complex within a 2-mile radius. Actually, it's about 1.6 miles of apartments in the area. And we are inundated. We thought we were having a quiet moratorium on apartments, and yet we're here with another apartment complex. We know that the we understand that the median income in our area is $39,000, and I was sitting here listening to that and thinking, how is that possible? Because in my community alone, I mean, I'm looking at people with multiple degrees and so forth. And now I realize that that median income would include all of the apartment complexes, and those people, or some of them, are under subsidy income, and some are under complete subsidy income, and then those there are some that are in affordable housing, and I would think that that would bring our income median down, and I'm positive that it would. And so I say that $39,000 doesn't really reflect the active tax-based community in the South Cobb area. Also, although our schools may be under-filled, they are undernourished in terms of sending out our kids with the appropriate things that they need to go on to middle school, et cetera, with the appropriate academics. So telling us that it's under-filled has no real bearing on people in our community because they're also under-educated in terms of the big scheme of Cobb County. Now, future redevelopment along Six Flags Corridor is what we're concerned, one of the other things we're concerned about. If we put this apartment complex in where it's proposed now, what are we going to do 2 years from now when another complex, someone comes in and they propose redevelopment of maybe one or two of those apartment complexes on Six Flags, which we would absolutely be happy to have. But in doing that, we're going to have to give those people incentives, and those incentives are going to be in numbers, which means they're going to be even more dense, which raises the number of apartment dwellers in our community. So I have a problem with that because we have to prepare for what we project Six Flags to look like, as well as the fact that we have some property that needs to be developed. And I think that we should consider that in our bid to deny or accept. I'm going to use the word deny because that's what I'm interested in, denying this particular zoning. We have crime that's an issue in our area. I know that you guys have agreed to a police, a mini precinct in the area, but I'm thinking more apartments. And with the onset of potential redevelopment, which will bring a major amount of apartments, we're going to need an absolute precinct, and we don't have that now. So we need to get crime under control in our area before we add more digits to that. In addition to that, because Six Flags is so close to Fulton Industrial and the apartments are going to be rented at a minimum of $800, I'm thinking there's going to be an influx from the type of people that we do not desire in our community, because $800 is affordable rent, period, whether the median income is $39,000 or not, because these apartments aren't going to be based on what your income, they're going to be based on you being able to pay the rent. So I'm interested in finding out more about how we're going to keep undesirable people or elements from our community. $800 is not a lot of money in the big scheme of things today. We do want better development in Six Flags, and we do want tax-based development in Six Flags, and we do want jobs. This particular development offers no offer no real job opportunities for our teens or for some of the people who are there under subsidy income. So that's another reason why I believe that this development is not a good development for our community. I would ask that the commissioners consider changing the zoning if this particular petition is denied. Consider changing the zoning from the NS, the LI, and the TS, as well as the R20, to something like maybe a RA5 or a live-work community or something other than this combination. Because I find that one of the unfortunate situations with the homeowners that are closest to this development is that they're novices in the big world of zoning. And because they're in fear of what could happen, they're willing to accept what is happening. And because of that, I think that they're under the misguided impression that this development is the best that we can get there. And honestly, I know that it is not the best that we can get there. And I think that because they're, I want to use the word, somewhat intimidated, in fear of what could happen, that they're accepting what is being offered to them. And I think there's a better offer out there. There were 19 people appearing before the Planning Commission, and they're not here today. It's not because they don't have the same interests or that they are not lacking in opposition. It's because they're torn within themselves as to what's the worst of what could go there, you know. And I feel like we're being used like whores in our community, going out to the best person who's going to pay the best money for our community, and we're trying to get out of that. You know, we've accepted, when we accepted Walton Reserve in our community, we were under the misguided thinking that it was going to provide more opportunities for better development. And Walton Communities has been a wonderful accomplishment for our area, but it hasn't brought in anything better to our area, but it hasn't made it worse, per se, although the homes haven't been sold the way that we thought, and the developer did leave before the homes were developed. So we're not receiving, thus far, the things that we need to make our community more viable and better for us. And although this is probably a wonderful development, and I'm sure that they're giving us some of the best that they can give us, it's still not what we desire for our community. Thank you.
Thank you.